And finally, you get to stage a big dance break in the El Café Cubana in Havana. And it's like a, it's like, this was huge, I expect, in the 1940s and 40s and 50s, but Afro-Cuban was the height of exotica at the time. And you get a huge exotic number like that to stage in this nightclub in the Hotel El Nacionali in Havana. I mean, where like Meyer Lansky and all those guys went.
Okay, so how do you do this in a theater that barely hits 300 seats and has no fly gallery and really no wings?
I should have showed you the section I just showed.
How do you do this? Here's the designer's challenge, right?
Well, you do it. You gotta find a way to do it.
How?
Yeah, well,
we'll look at the maquette in a second.
Look at the maquettes. Okay. Better still come see the show, you know, if you're ever around Montreal then. But, I mean, there's a way to do it. There's a way to do it if you, you know, like, simply evoking those nightclubs and stuff. And plus, you have to evoke several locations in and around Manhattan, especially around the Times Square area. There are many, many locations. Well, the street is the main decor.
And can I ask what the budget is for this? I mean, you as a designer, you actually have the practical side and the design side. You have a budget envelope, and you have to produce that given that. How do you, if your budget is small, then that's going to affect what you actually create.
Yeah, but, you know, you get away with all the street decor locations by doing a fantastic street drop, like the one you saw a study for it earlier there. And so when it comes to the scene, the manhole cover, you know, where they're going to go play craps in the sewer, all you need to do is the manhole cover, you know. It's just like, okay, boys, you know, then there's a lighting change, you get rid of that. The other curtain goes out, and you have a long ladder coming down, a lot of smoke, and a cone of light, as if light's pouring in from...
And how do you have a long ladder coming down in the Seagull that has no flies?
You simply bring a ladder with this, that has two hooks on it, like that. And while the street drop is in with the manhole in front of it, you bring in the ladder, hook it onto the grid, and then... You know, and then you get maybe the most agile guy to go up about 5 or 6 steps, and then one guy just stepping off it, the rest of the guys assembled around it. Lots of smoke, cone of light.
Right.
And as the street drops, goes out an oleo, not flown out, has to go on an oleo.
Right.
You come up and they're just coming. So you've gone from like this to this. You know what
and
I mean?
And an oleo is basically rolling it on a
on a drum.
On a drum.
Like that, yeah. But I need that act drop, the street drop, to be able to come in and out, because those shows are written, the spectacle in those shows is written to be revealed, you know, in scene after scene. And it's, they're alternate. The narrower street scenes can happen downstage of the street drop, whereas the bigger ones, like the club and all the rest of them, can happen upstage of the act curtain. So, I mean, so you can create a situation, even in a smaller theater like this one, that allows you to use the structure and the sequence of those scenes in the way, exactly the way it's written,